Hey, my name is Jack, and this is the second video of my tutorial series in which I explain how else systems work in animation nodes. Last time we looked at how a string of text can be transformed into geometry, but as you can see, to create this fairly simple structure, the text you would have to type looks very complex. So to create even more complex structures, typing it all out by hand is not really a viable option. Fortunately, there's a better way to do it, and that is what I want to show you in this video. To understand why it is even possible to do it in a better way, we have to look at the structure more closely. As you can see, it is fairly repetitive, so at every point here, the same thing happens. Every time a branch ends, we get two new branches where one goes to the left and one goes to the right. Now let's try to capture that in our text. So basically we start at the beginning with one branch and then we want to go to the right and to the left. But because we want to do that again and again, it makes sense to use a variable instead that we can replace later on. So the A basically does nothing except it is there so that we can replace it later. That's why it's called a symbol variable. Now let's use a replace text node and replace the A with a branch to the left and a branch to the right. So far we haven't won much, but we know the A represents this branching and we want that at the end of each of these new branches, the same happens again. We can just insert the A here and we are good to go. Now it still looks the same, but the good thing is we can repeat this replacement multiple times, and every time an A gets replaced by two branches. As you can see, that looks fairly very repetitive, so I prepared a little subprogram that does exactly that multiple times in a row. And here you go. It just takes the text, replaces the A by this new structure, branching to the right and branching to the left, and then repeats the same process again and again. If you want to see how that subprogram looks, it is here. Yeah, it's nothing too fancy. The good thing is this replacement of text is a very fundamental technique in else systems, so the else system node itself provides a better way to do it, and this is what the rules are for. We start with FA again, but now we can define a rule which means we want to replace an A by this branch to the right and another branch to the left. And nothing happened so far because we are generation zero. So generation zero means that we only take the axiom. But if we go at generation one, this replacement happens exactly once. So we get this, and then we can go to generation 2, and so on and so forth. And the A system implementation I wrote also supports fractional generations, which will result in an interpolation between different generations. So as you can see, now we can... It is very easy to define more complex structures by just changing this rule. For example, we could also rotate in another direction and do the same thing again, and now we get already this kind of tree. So in the next video we will look at some other rules, and see you then.